Have you ever wondered why some colors look better than others? Today we're going to talk about this topic and I'll show you how to pick the best colors for you. This is going to be a three-part series, so we're going to talk about your skin tone and undertones, how to define your color season, and how to mix and match colors. This is part one. We're going to be talking about skin tone and how to analyze yours. First of all, I would like to say that for some reason, it's a common misconception that dark-skinned people don't need to wear sunscreen. That's not true. Please take care of your beautiful skin and wear SPF. Skin tones vary a lot. They can go from the darkest brown-blue shades to the lightest hues. Your skin color changes depending on different factors. The main factor is the amount of melanin you have on your skin. Other factors can be genetics and your sun exposure. Black people come in every shade depending on those factors we talked before. I divided our skin tones in 6 sections: deep dark brown, brown, light brown, and medium. Deep dark brown. These are the girls with really rich dark skin tones. Sometimes, because of their shade, they can have a blue or violet tint to them, giving the skin tone the name of blue-black. Some examples are Nikki and Ducky Thought, Nima Tang, Viola Davis, Anok Jai, and Lupita Nyong'o. Now we have dark brown. They are kind of a milk chocolate color. They are very dark, but they are not as dark as the deep dark brown girls. So we have to make a distinction because they have different color palettes for them. Some examples of dark brown girls are Kelly Rowland, Naomi Campbell, Maria Borges, Jackie Aina, also Kira, and Normani. Now we have brown. They have a caramel complexion, they look golden or a bit orange. Some examples would be Angela Bassett, Queen Latifah, Kerry Washington, Megan Good, and Halima Aden. Now we have light brown. It's not the same as light-skinned. They have a lighter brown complexion, similar to a peanut color. Some examples would be Jada Pinkett Smith, Halle Berry, Beyoncé, and Slick Woods. Medium or light-skinned. This is what would be considered light-skinned black people, like Alicia Keys, Zendaya, Zoe Kravitz, Jasmine Brown, Alyssa Ashley, and Arnell Armin. And finally, we have the fair skin tone, usually black albinos like Deandra Forrest and Joanne Dion. Now that we have covered skin tones, we will be covering undertones. So, an undertone is the color you have beneath your skin surface. Your skin tone might change between seasons, but your undertone does not change. This can be a little bit confusing, especially for black people, because we tend to have different colorations on our body. But in this case, we're going to be looking at the majority of your face. We have 3 undertones: warm, neutral, and cool. You have a warm undertone when the base of your skin is warm, if you have a yellow, golden, or peach tint. You are neutral if your skin isn't especially cool or warm, just right in the middle. You might look slightly green or gray. You have a cool undertone if your skin has hints of pink, red, or blue. You can find many methods on how to determine your undertone, but I feel like the best options are the foundation method and the veins method. The first method is looking at your veins. If they look green, you have a warm undertone. If they are blue or purple, you are cool. And if you have both, you're neutral. You can look at the inner part of your arm or the inside of your wrist. Because we are talking about dark skin tones, this can be a little bit hard because not everyone can see their vein color. So I would recommend the second method. I feel like this is the best method to know your undertone, especially if you can't see your veins. And this would be the foundation method. If you use a warm foundation, you are warm. If you use a cool foundation, you are cool. And if you use a neutral foundation, you are neutral. Sometimes the neutral foundation would say you are a neutral cool or a neutral warm. This means you're neutral, but you lean against the warm or cool spectrums. this is definitely the best method. I would recommend you get professionally matched in a makeup store like Sephora. It's free and you just have to ask to try out their foundations. If you already have a perfectly matched foundation, all you have to do is check on the package if it's warm, cool or neutral. And if it doesn't say, just type the name and shade on Google and you will find that information. For example, if you go on the Fenty website, you just have to pick the shade and in this part you can see if it's cool, warm or neutral. Now we're going to pair skin tones with the undertones and look at some examples so you can see the difference. First, we have deep brown. I placed this chart with the undertones right next to each other to help you understand the difference. Something you might have noticed is that deep brown skin tones are mostly cool or neutral toned. You can be warm toned, but most of the times you're cool or neutral. Blue-black people have a blue or purple undertone that makes them look cool. It gives them a natural frosty appearance. You can also have a red undertone, and that means you are cool toned. Neutral toned skin can have a green or gray tint to it. You can also have a cool neutral undertone. This means you might use a neutral foundation mixed with a cool foundation. Next, we have dark brown. And we have the chart with the undertones right next to each other. We have the warm, the cool, and the neutral undertone. Like I said before, you are warm if you have a yellow, golden, or peach tint to your face. And you are neutral toned if your skin has kind of like a gray or green undertone. You can also be neutral warm or neutral cool. Brown. We also have the chart with the warm, the neutral, and the cool undertones. Remember, you are warm if you have a yellow tint, and you are cool if you have a red tint. And you are neutral if you have a green or gray tint. Now we have the light brown girls. Again, this is the chart that will help you understand the difference. We have cool, neutral, and warm. You are cool if you have a red undertone. You are neutral if you have a green or gray undertone. And you are warm if you have a yellow undertone. Now we have the light-skinned girls. We have the warm, neutral, and cool again. You are warm if you have a yellow or a peach undertone. You are neutral if you have like a green or gray tint to your face. And you're cool if you have a red undertone. At last, we have the fair girls, usually the black albinos. And we have warm Deandra Forest and cool Joanne Dion. It can be a little bit hard to know your undertone just by looking at your skin and your veins, unless you're a professional. This is why I highly recommend you get matched in a makeup store. Next video will be about how to determine your season. But first, you also need to know that your hair and eyes also have undertones. You have a warm undertone if your hair has a red, yellow, or orange tint. This is kind of weird because in skin tones, if you have a red undertone, you are cool. But in hair, you have a warm undertone if you have red. You have cool hair if your hair has a bluish, violet, or green tint to it. You can have any hair color and be warm or cool. Here are a few examples so you can see the difference in each case. The first color we have is blonde. You can be warm or cool. As you can see, the warm one is a lot more orange and the cool one is a little bit ashy. Warm blondes tend to be more yellow and golden, like strawberry blondes and honey blondes. Cool toned blondes look grayed out or silver toned, platinum blonde or ash blonde. Here are some examples of warm blondes and how warm blonde looks on dark skinned people and how cool blonde looks on dark skinned people. Now we have brown. You have the cool brown and the warm brown. The warm brown looks a little bit more red and the cool brown looks a little bit ashy, even a little bit blue. Warm browns tend to be more yellow and golden, like chocolate brown and golden brown. Cool toned brown looks grayed out and ashy like ash brown and walnut brown. Here are some examples on how warm brown looks on dark-skinned people and how cool brown looks on dark-skinned people. Now we have black. I feel like black can be the hardest shade to know if you have a warm black or a cool black, because jet black is always cool. If you have a warm black, it's usually an off-black color. It can be a little bit red or a little bit yellow, but if it's jet black, it's always gonna be cool. Warm blacks tend to be more red or have warm brown highlights like off-black and cherry black. Cool-toned blacks look a bit blue or purple like jet black. And finally, we have red. Natural red hair is almost always warm because they have a yellow or red tint to it. Now, if you have cool red hair, it usually has a purple or violet tint to it. Here we have a few examples of warm red. It's very rich, it looks red, it looks orange, it can look a little bit like brownish. And if you look at the cool red, it can be like a copper with a hint of blue, or it can look violet. With eyes, it's really easy. You have warm eyes if they have golden, yellow, red, or light brown colors in them. And you have cool eyes if they are blue, green, gray, cool black, with no brown in them. Thank you for watching my video, and leave a like and subscribe if you liked it. Don't forget, you can DM me on Instagram if you have any questions, and turn on your notifications so you don't miss the next video. It will be about the method I developed to determine your decision if you are dark-skinned. Have a nice day, and I hope to see you soon.